Within intensive care medicine, we've gotten better at helping patients survive their severe illness in the intensive care unit. And as a result, we have a growing number of patients who are ICU survivors. As this patient population grows, we're beginning to understand the consequences these patients have when they go home. We've understood that patients have many problems with muscle weakness that prevents them from returning to work and requires prolonged rehabilitation. We've also recognized that there are many difficulties with depression, anxiety, and post-traumatic stress disorder related to their ICU stay. As a result of this, we've begun to rethink how we provide care to patients in the intensive care unit. It's very normal for most patients in the intensive care unit to be deeply sedated and receive bed rest throughout the duration of their stay in the intensive care unit.
It's really important that patients are up and moving, because if they stay in the bed all day, we know that they lose a lot of strength, and we know that they can get tightness in their joints, problems with their lungs.
As a result, at Johns Hopkins Hospital, we've thought about rethinking the way we deliver care in the intensive care unit. We've thought about, what if we have patients wider awake and have patients up and moving despite being on life support in the intensive care unit?
We know that one of the worst things we can do probably is to leave someone in bed. So anything that they can do activity-wise, we really try to promote.
We're talking about a shift in paradigm in caring for patients in the intensive care unit, reducing over-sedation, reducing delirium, and getting patients mobile when they're in the intensive care unit. We introduced rehabilitation staff, physical medicine and rehabilitation concepts early into intensive care. We now have occupational physical therapists and rehabilitation physicians seeing patients while they're in the intensive care unit rather than at the end of their hospital stay. So what patients overwhelmingly tell us is that they like the early physical medicine rehabilitation. They like being awake. They certainly like getting out of bed and moving. It shows them that there's hope. It shows them that there's a life beyond the intensive care unit and a life for them to get back to. It gives them goals for improvement when they see themselves walking a little further each day. It shows them that they can get better. This is something that I believe other intensive care units can also implement to improve the longer-term outcomes of their intensive care patients.